Hey everybody, I'm coming back with a thrift store haul that I talked about the other day, just clothes and a few books. So, first up, as you can see, now that we know Baby is actually a girl and not a boy, I did find a couple of pieces. I'm not really looking for anything. It's just if I come across it and I think it's cute, I'll go ahead and get it. But all this stuff, the tags are still on it, but everything was pretty much half price. So first is just this long sleeves onesie. It's a just 1 year card, size small. It says "Mommy loves me." It's never been worn. It's a pretty, like a light turquoise and hot pink. And next up is a jamboree skirt with the little birdies on it. And I had actually seen this several times, and I finally went back and got it because I just kept saying how cute, and I wish I could use it. So here it is, and it was marked $1.98, but like I said, everything was half price. And next we have this little jamboree outfit, and it was actually, it was an outfit. One of the lines from last year. I just like the little ladybugs on little girls' clothes. But it's in fairly good condition. And it is a 3 to 6 month. Whew, I'm already out of breath. That's bad. Next, this little top was just so cute. And we have quite a few pieces from this line. I try to stay away from cream, but like I said, it was just too cute. And normally when they're this small, they don't tend to mess up. I don't have to worry about them eating a lot, and if they do, I just take it off and wait till they finish eating. And this is a 3 to 6 month. It was $1.98. And this purchase was actually a eBay purchase. I'm just going to throw it in here because it just came in the mail yesterday. But I mainly got it because there's a pair of boots that go with this outfit, and the outfit was just too cute, and it was a great deal. So again, the little doggies. This is a 2T, and yeah, it's got the little cheetah print or giraffe print on the trim here. And it's real furry, different textures here. I like that. And then here's another top that goes with that. And this top is also a 2T. Oh boy. And here are the pants. And the outfit was worn. It wasn't worn a lot. And she was really great on the description. I like the little detail on the pockets. And the little detail on the leg. And here are the boots. My daughter loves boots. And so I left them on the bed. And immediately when she came in, she saw these boots. And I told the girls, I said, she's going to put these boots on and wear these boots every single day. And she actually tried to wear them to school today. But, yeah, she's a boot girl. And these are basically brand new. So, they're size 8. And, the whole outfit was $20, which was great because the boots alone, I'm sure, were about $25. So That's why I said it's such a great deal. And I know the jeans, their jeans run between $30-$35. And the tops were probably $20 a piece. So, you know, I couldn't beat that. So, next we have just a shirt for son. It's a size 3T. It is running big because normally I'm buying him 4s and 5s. This is a, let's see the tag, a Jamie and Jack. Yeah, something different. I like the detail on the collar. The color's real great. It hadn't been worn that much. I'm starting to collect clothes for fall because I know all their things pretty much need to be replaced. And we need some things to make it to our consignment sale in October. So, next up, I found these pants, and my son loves trains, and I just had to have them. And so I went ahead and picked them up. They were $1.98. Khaki pants, and this is also Janie and Jack. And they're size 4. And they're in great condition. And I kept looking, and I came across the vest. And I just thought, okay, how cute. And then I said, okay, there has to be a third piece to it. It took me about 20 minutes to find the top. I had to think about what shirt might look like it would go under this vest. But I did find it. So, the vest is also 4. And here is the top. It is it's a 5. And it's a good used condition outfit. This was probably a picture outfit. But it's really, I like it. It's really heavy duty. And I showed it to him and he liked it. So I'm pretty sure he will get a lot of wear out of this. I'm not sure if we'll do pictures in it, but I'll miss something. Next up, I found these adorable cords, and this is coming off like a bluish color, but it's actually a deep purple, and they're in great condition, maybe worn once. And they are a 4T. They're children's place. And so I will probably have to put these up for next year. But for this price, like I said, half price, I could not pass this up. It's got the little bow on the, a bow detail on the pocket. Whew. Okay, next we have another pair. This is a Gymboree pair. This pair has been worn a little more, but still great condition. It's got some heart detail on the pockets. And it's a 4. And let's turn these over. It's got these little slash pockets in the back with the hearts. I thought that was cute. And next we have a pair of 5 Gymboree cords. And these have the embellishment on the bottom, so there's a top somewhere. I may run across it, but if not, we can always find something to go with it. I know we have some pieces from this line in a smaller size, though, so I'm sure I'll run across it. And these are like a lime green, so something really different with color, but cute. And then we have the little ribbon detail on the back pocket. And these little capris, I passed a couple times, a couple days, but I finally went back and they still had them. It's a Gymboree size 2T. The little veggies. I just like the design on the bottom. Thought that was really cute. And saw these little tops. I saw one at first, and I said, okay, I have to get this. I was born to be a princess. Normally, I don't buy things like this, but they were just cute. And then when I looked to the side of it, I actually found the other one. And the girl said, Mom, why do you always make the girls match? I said, well, because it's there. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. But this is a Carter's 18-month, and this one is a 4. So we can always use tops to go with jeans or whatever. Next up, we have a pair of pants. And these are Oshkosh. These are 4T. And I'm thinking they may be about an inch or so too long. And I'll probably end up hemming them up if I don't put them up for next year. But I think if I just hem them a little bit, they'll be fine. I like the bow on the pockets and the color. And these are look like they were barely worn. So, and ironically, this top up next matches. So I may, like I said, I may just go ahead and hem them and use them for this year, because this top is a 2. And actually, both the girls can fit it, but I was getting it mainly for Layla for now. And I passed this top up a couple times just because it's a cream top, but for half the price, again, I couldn't leave it. It was just too cute. And next we have a pair of embellished jeans. They are Gap, Baby Gap, 18-24 month. Just like the flower detail on the leg. Some nice colors. We can pair it pretty much with different color tops or sweaters or what have you. And the back pockets also have that design. And a girl can never have too many jeans. So. And then we have this Gymboree top, and this is brand new. It's never been washed or worn. And I like the bow detail on the sleeve, the little cupcakes. It's a size 3, so we will find something to match, or we may already have something to match, but I'll use this with some jeans or some leggings. And maybe I'll find a sweater if we don't already have one. And that'll be a great transition into fall. And this top, I just love the little penguins and the little dots and colors. So, this is a Carter's. This is a 3. And it has this little twofer look under the bottom. Oh, I like that. And then we have a pair of Gymboree overalls. These are, I think, 12 to 18 months, yeah. But they are running long. Baby is really, she's really petite and small, so I know that they won't be too short on her. And they have the snap between the legs, so easy diaper changes when she's at school. I just love little overalls on girls. I think they're just adorable. And I know we have a top to go with it. A little button detail on the side. And next we have just a little Gymboree dress. It's an 18 to 24 month. And actually, my intention is to use this for Layla now. And, put a pair of shorts under it, like the little knit biker shorts, and then as it gets cooler, I will put a pair of leggings with it. That way she can transition, and then we'll throw a top underneath the top. of or underneath the dress. So this will go pretty long ways. We like the little ocean theme on it. And then this little sweater, jamboree sweater, is a 4T, and this is in excellent condition. It's coming off a dark brown color, but it's actually like a deep plum. And I just love the little button detail at the top and all the colors. And this will be great for fall. I can just pretty much match anything with it. And this will last several years. So those green cords will actually go with this eventually. And so will the pink ones. But for the moment, she loves the sweater. She's been wearing it. I don't know what I'm going to put with it, but it was just too cute. And let's see, it was $1.98 half price. So again, for the price and the quality, we can always use this. And so next up, I have, I was taught the girls, or the kids, rather, sign language. And I just picked this little book because sometimes the girls will help with them. And they may need a reference because they don't know all the signs. So I found this little book in this particular thrift store. And all their books are a dime. So thought that would be pretty useful. And then for myself, I found this handy dandy recipe book, and this was something I was just thinking about doing because I have a lot of recipes I've been collecting that I need to do something with. I've pretty much been saving them in my phone or just trying to write down what I can, but I need them in a certain place because I may not be the one actually cooking it. So, and this just has a couple of pages with different things, substitutions for, I don't know if you can see this, there's cornstarch, flour, things like that, and weights and measurements, cooking terms, same thing, how much and how many, and what else? Herbs and spices. There's a roasting chart. Microwave tips. And just a little section dividers to tell you how to categorize your recipes. And then back here, we have the actual recipe cards, so I can start writing them down and writing the cooking time and the serving size. And then I will insert the dividers where they go, so it separates all the recipes. So, good buy for me. And then for the kids, we have a few books, and we have already quite a few books by this author. So I found this one, and like I said, the kids' books are, or really all of the books, are a dime. So we cannot pass these up. They never can have enough books. Here's the other one. Really simple. Even if I don't read it to them, they can pretty much look at the pages and figure out what's going on. And then this one, we've been reading this book over and over. They like this one, Who Stole the Cookie from the Cookie Jar. And of course, each page a cookie disappears until it gets to the end. And again, this book is really great condition. So, good story. And I found this one, Baby's First Library Animals. Sorry, guys, I'm out of breath. But yeah, we have quite a few books on animals, and this has some animals that they didn't know. So, and the baby really loves this book. But they like going through this book and just making the animal sounds as they turn the page. And it also tells them, like, there's a snail. A snail likes to eat lettuce. Who else likes to eat lettuce? And there's a bunny, a caterpillar, and a turtle. So, great learning. Snail, they didn't know what a snail was until now. And there's a mole. So, I thought that was a great buy. And it's a really thick book, too. And then the babies, are a little bit into Barney. The other kids like Barney. And so I saw these and I just went ahead and picked them up because really what they are these lift the flap books, and they like these books. So I figured I might as well go ahead and get them. And they've been using them because I actually had to go to another room to get them just to show them. And here's another one. And so, basically that one is shapes on that page. And then there's Barney at the circus. Oh, yeah. And what else? These are actually not thrift hauls. We went out and took the girls to Office Depot. Well, actually everybody went. But when we went to Office Depot last night, and went school shopping, they needed their summer school supplies. They start school on the 12th, their summer school. They do summer school for 2 weeks before actual school. And the babies picked up some things, of course. And actually, I don't know, both of them had one of these, but I guess one of them put it back. And so we only have one. But, yeah, I don't know how we'll figure out how to use it because the markers and the babies don't really mix. But I just have to monitor them. And they're washable, too. And then we found this little toddler activity book. And it says for preschool and kindergarten. But I like it because it's wipe-off pages. And you can see somebody's already started writing on it. But something to give them to do. They wanted school supplies, too. And it just has basic trace the letters. And then the animal or whatever picture that coordinates with it. And yeah, we can see somebody colored the ball already. And what else? I think there's some more stuff back here. Oh, yeah, some mazes. So, yeah, Daddy said they can have the books, so he bought the books. Of course, they were running around picking up everything in the store. And he just let them. But this is what they ended up with. And these pages actually tear out, but of course we're not going to tear them out. We're just going to leave them in the book since they can do it over and over once we erase them. So, yeah. And I think I will do the school supply haul once I can go get the girls' stuff because they pretty much split their stuff up, but there's some pretty neat things. Like they bought some lunch containers that I thought may be helpful for somebody. I hope you guys enjoyed this haul. It was a rather long one. And again, I thank you guys for watching the videos and showing your support. I love your comments. And the girls love your comments. They have comments back. But yeah, you see they're quite hilarious at times. I say that's my girls. And if you guys like these videos, just thumbs up the video. And if you have any more if you have any requests, just let me know and I'll be more than happy to get them out there. Let's see what else. I don't know, I may do another update on baby after this video. I'm just not sure. I'm kind of running behind. I know I said I had a I wanted to do my diaper stash video, the entire stash, but some things threw me off this week. Me being sick and the baby's been sick, it kind of threw me off again. So I will have to get that out sometime in the next couple weeks. But enjoy your day. Talk with you guys later. Bye-bye.